there. This is Amish. This is Karan.
Hi.
I've never done a vlogging day in the life of kind of a thing, but I thought, you know, let's give it a shot, especially because, you know, I'm not going to be the one doing the shooting. It's going to be Karan. And of course, there are, you know, other issues such as the fact that you can't really take your camera or your phone or anything at all inside the court. In fact, that's a valuable lesson that people should remember, that if you're going to court, be it as a lawyer or a law student or even a litigant for that matter, you can never record either video or audio or anything of that sort. In fact, a couple of days ago, a lawyer called me up and told me that a friend of his had taken a picture of him while he was arguing a matter and had sent it to him. And he thought that because all these other lawyers are putting up pictures of themselves doing video conferencing with judges, and they've also put up the pictures of the judges as well, in that kind of a situation, even he should be allowed to put up a picture of himself addressing physical arguments before a court. And that was the High Court of Delhi, no less. I had to explain to him that that is a strict no-no. You invite the wrath of the court, there is contempt of court, there are all these other things that you will face if you get into this kind of a situation. So even if you want to record audio, in fact, I don't remember the name of the advocate. He, I think, is a recent entrant into the legal market, and I kind of agree with him that all court proceedings should have audio and video recordings. The reasoning given by the courts is that the independence of the judge and the discretion to deal with matters kind of goes away. But I say, why not? Right? If you are a public authority or a judge or whatever you want to call it, you know, we've got different definitions. Someone will come up and say that a judge is not a public authority. A judge is whatever the statute or whatever the act of the parliament says the judge is, be it a judge of the Supreme Court, be it the High Court, or be it a district judiciary judge. I personally believe everything should be there online, not online per se, but everything should be available as a matter of record, because I personally have seen, I would say, 1 out of 3 cases that whatever I am submitting to the court, or not each and every one of those submissions is considered by the court, because the judge also does not want to get into technical points on several occasions, and the judge wants to dispose of the matter and say, bhai, meri tension nahi hai, ye to upar wale, upar se isko tum theek karao. And because of that, there is a huge challenge that lawyers face all the time, and the challenge is that I am making my submissions, I am doing all these things, yet the judge is perhaps giving a one page order, or even if the judge wants to give a detailed order, the details in the order will be more to do with 80% of the judgments. In fact, there have been occasions where the judge has stated in the order that the counsel for either of the parties has relied upon ABC judgments, when actually none of those judgments has been relied upon. And not just to pass an order in someone's favor, that I can still understand. The counsel may not be that equipped, and that's why the judge did some own research and kind of attributed it to one of the counsels. But when dismissing or when not giving the relief, even then the judge is saying that the counsel for the, you know, whatever party that they are not giving the relief to has cited these judgments, and for this reason these judgments are not applicable. My point is, if all of this is going to happen, of course nobody wants to admit it, right? There are several things in this country that judges, that politicians, that nobody wants to acknowledge. Another thing, a very, very prevalent thing, everyone will talk about it in a one-on-one situation. Karan and I here sitting will talk about it for the next half an hour, about how bad the police in this country are, and about how, although they've got no job, and apart from extorting money from people, they are still a necessary evil, because if you don't have these, for the lack of a better word, these goons running around, if you don't have these people running around, you will have the traditional sense, you know, gundas coming around, coming and terrorizing people, and it's going to be total anarchy. In fact, I keep reading about the Black Lives Matter movement and the Defund the Police movement. I mean, Black Lives Matter, I don't know much about. But Defund the Police? Hashtag Defund the Police. is something which I find to be so funny. I mean, if you are not going to have law enforcement, what are you going to do? In fact, you know, I mean, people who are watching this who kind of want to learn more about how crazy this whole idea of defund the police is, you should follow a couple of these people. PragerU.com, and PragerU has these incredible videos on YouTube. And there's this guy Ben Shapiro. He's the I think the editor in chief, or I think till recently he was the editor in chief of this online newspaper called The Daily Wire. And he's I believe a right wing conservative Republican American. Fascinating stuff, because I can draw a lot of analogies with what's going on over there and the kind of sentimentalities and the kind of public opinion that is here in India. Anyways, coming back to the point, whether we should allow proceedings to be recorded, I think it's a given. I mean, everyone knows, all lawyers at least, who will watch this will agree with me when I say that like 90% of the times, the judge, statistically, or maybe at least 60 to 70% of the times, the judge will not even record whatever you have said. So it's a huge cause for concern. And what are you going to do? You know, you can't really do anything except, you know, tell the appellate court judge that we made this submission. Or what I like to do, and I've talked about it in a previous video as well, is that you file written submissions at the time of final arguments, so that you can show, then the file goes up to the appellate court judge, you can show to the judge that these were written submissions submitted by me. So there can be no doubt that I have made this argument, I have tendered these submissions. But even then, the whole point is accountability. If you have court proceedings being recorded, the kind of haphazard, the half-baked way that some, very handful of, but some judges perform in, and also the majority of the lawyers, we us, and I am myself quite guilty of it on several occasions. I have crossed the boundaries of impropriety, and I have kind of act a little uncouth, a little unadvocate-like, and I would also want to rectify myself, but we have no incentive to do that. So these were just a couple of, you know, thoughts while we are on our way to Gurgaon court today to argue a matter which we've been going on for the past couple of weeks. It's a terrible tragedy. We're for the complainant, and hopefully we'll get some relief for the complainant. I also coincidentally got a call from a friend who had been charged under section 188 of the IPC, the infamous, the notorious 188 IPC. He's been charged with, and in fact Karan bhai sahab ne khud itne sare, matlab 188 ke case abhi tak kitne ho gaye tumhare?
Sir, mein 5 ho chuke.
5 cases total. It's insane. I was telling somebody else that my associate will be doing more matters, pulling in more revenue, and I'll have to kind of ask him to, you know, to include me in the partnership. There'll be Karan Ahuja and Associates. But so you know, this friend of mine, us time pe bhi jab iska hua tha, to he kind of called me up and he asked me what needs to be done. So I kind of guided him through it. He got his vehicle released, and in fact, thanks a lot to Karan, because Karan was actually able to help my friend out with his doubts, and that is why how he was able to kind of get his car out. But now my friend called up last night and said that he has been summoned by the police. I mean, the officer called him up and said that you have an appearance before the learned magistrate. And let's see how that goes. Let's see, I mean, what the whole deal is about. I told him that if the judge has called you, if you have a hearing, and apart from the whole thing of your vehicle being released, then in all likelihood the charge sheet has been filed by the police. And now what's going to happen is that the police must have filed the charge sheet. And in fact, this is something that happens at a regular basis, so we should all know about it. When the police completes the investigation, they submit what is called a charge sheet before the court. Charge sheet or a closure report, whatever it is. Closure report says that we investigated, no offense was found. Charge sheet is the entire story of the investigation conducted on the offenses made out. If the police feels that there is an offense which is made out, then they will go ahead and file a charge sheet. After filing of charge sheet, the magistrate applies his or her mind to the file and then takes cognizance of the matter while issuing summons to the accused person. So I am guessing that in this case, the natural outcome of the So, I mean, I'm not sure about what the outcome is going to be, but if the person has been called to the court, in all likelihood, the charge sheet has been submitted and the accused person has been summoned. Now, I told this friend that in all likelihood, we will just plead guilty. But the trick to figure out whether we want to plead guilty or not, because I have done that on prior occasions, you need to go. The one trick that I kind of think is, you know, might be helpful for all these other people who will be watching, who will also be doing, who will be, you know, dealing with 188 IPC, is that you go ahead, you you know, maybe 10-15 minutes or half an hour before the judge sits, you talk to the reader and you ask the reader of the court about the offense that the allegation has been of. And you ask the reader that if we plead guilty, what has been the track record of the judge? Has the judge ever, on any other occasion, sentenced the person to imprisonment? And, you know, a lot of judges do this. They will sentence the person to you know, minor offenses, even significantly major ones according to the statute. The statute will say the punishment is of 5 years or 3 years. And the judge will sentence you for TRC. So, you know, TRC means till the rising of the court, which means that the accused person has been directed to suffer, I don't know what you want to call it, imprisonment, incarceration, at the back of the courtroom till the rising of the court. So, till the time the judge gets up, you are supposed to stand at the back as a form of a very, you know, school-like punishment where you just stand at the back and, you know, you kind of feel the shame and the humiliation and you think about what your actions are and kind of improve on your actions. But trust me, my friend, the one who was charged under 188 IPC, I am quite confident he has had his, he's learned his lesson, because once you get involved with the police, you know, file these charges against you, you have to get your vehicle released, all of this nonsense that happens, it's a very good chance, although I'm not in favor of it, but I still feel that, you know, to at least dissuade the members of the public from going ahead and doing whatever they want, actions like these should maybe carry a little bit of consequence so that the public also feels a little apprehension in doing whatever they plan to do. And yeah, I think I'm out of content right now. I'm pretty thirsty as well. But this is a vlog. This is going to be a pretty lengthy one, I'm quite confident, because I want the first one to be decent, right? So I'm gonna be, of course, I cannot shoot any video inside the court complex, or I mean, I can do that, but I can definitely not shoot a court, like the thing about what we're gonna be doing inside the courtroom. Of course, the identity of the clients is also, of course, anonymous, but we will kind of maybe give a few glimpses of the what the court complex looks like, and also we can kind of talk about what all happened when we were at court today. Hopefully it works out. If it doesn't work out, you will find out still. So we are back. We're driving back to the office because we had a very, very productive day at Gurgaon Courts. When we went there, it was raining like crazy. We waited in the car in the parking lot for about half an hour, or I think around half an hour, right?
Yes, sir.
Around half an hour. And then when the rain kind of went down a little, we had a little adventure of our own, you know, you must have seen that already. And when we reached the court, I first went to assist my friend because I was hoping that it will be a short matter. Turns out that, as I predicted, the investigating officer in the case had to file his charge sheet, also called the challan, in the court. And that is why he called the friend, that is the accused person, so that if he wants, he can straight away come plead guilty and be done with the matter. Now, when he reaches court, the investigating officer does not pick his calls. He calls up somebody else who knew the investigating officer, and the investigating officer told that person, apparently, that because of whatever reason, he is not going to come. And because of that, the friend came all the way from his house, spent around 3 hours here for no use at all. Now, coming to my case and my client was also in the parking lot. I was there in the parking lot for half an hour. We had this little adventure. We finally went to court. And so while I was with my friend and sorting out his matter, Karan bhai sahab calls me up and tells me that the judge is on leave. and the matter has now been adjourned to day after tomorrow. So this is, you know, this is, in fact, I think this is the number one lesson for lawyers and law students who want to get into litigation. If you want to make it big, or if you hope to make it big someday, you have to remember, chahe tum first year ya minus first year mein ho, or even if you are maybe 40 or 50 or 60 years down the line and you're a Ram Jethmalani, the judge can still be on leave, or all of these other things will happen because of which several hours of your day will go completely waste. And that is a major grouse that I have with the system, that a lot of other people also have with the system. In fact, I think I saw an interview of a corporate lawyer who said in the interview that he was doing quite well as a litigator, but he chose to leave it because of the several number of hours wasted every single day. And that's the reason why, in fact, I, after several months of introspection, of research, of strategizing, I filed my first PIL, my first public interest litigation, in the Delhi High Court for this reason itself. And the prayer that was there in my PIL, which was filed in 2019, August of 2019, was that we lawyers come to court and we, you know, we have several matters in a day on some occasions, and we leave one matter for the benefit of another matter, and in that other matter for which we have prepared thoroughly, we brave, you know, maybe an hour or 2 hours or 3 hours of traffic to reach the court. We spend another half an hour trying to find parking, trying to get to the courtroom, and if we are late by 5 or 10 minutes, we know that the judge might pass an adverse order against us. So we are rushing like crazy. We've got this elevated heart rate, elevated blood pressure, all of this tension, and when we reach the court, we see that the judge is on leave. And that's the reason why I filed this PIL, and I said that I'm just asking for a small thing. All I'm asking, all we hope for, is that if the judge has decided that the judge will not come to court, the court staff, our phone numbers of the lawyers, of the litigants, are all there on the record. Just the court staff just needs to, you know, pick up the phone, take 30 seconds on every case, maybe make 50-60 phone calls, which will take perhaps 20 minutes. But a cumulative of maybe 400 or 500 hours of human effort, which could be utilized elsewhere in perhaps, you know, working on cancer research, or on making more money, or on, you know, spending more time with loved ones, whatever it is, could be spent doing, you know, it could be spent doing something else rather than coming to court, waiting it out, and then finding out that the learned judge is on leave. Unfortunately, and in fact, the Chief Justice of the Delhi High Court also agreed with me and said that no judicial order needs to be passed, and appropriate order will be passed on the administrative side. Now, I understand, you know, these things take time. The matter has been adjourned from time to time with the assurance every time that appropriate orders, necessary orders, will be passed on the administrative side. And, you know, I mean, you know, the matter was supposed to be taken up, and I think around 18th of March, unfortunately, the matter was again adjourned because of the lockdown, and then it has been subsequently being adjourned again and again. Hopefully, we'll find some respite in the future, especially now that there is this whole pandemic scare that is happening. By the way, you know, I understand that I'm not wearing a mask. That's why I told Karan to wear the mask, so that we can maintain that little bit of social distancing. But yes, of course, I've got my mask right here. Please don't file a case against me. Please don't, you know, go ahead and push me under Section 188. Nahi to pata chala main kisi aur ki madad karne ja raha hu under 188, and mere ko hi jana pad raha hai saath saath, to kind of also answer for my sins of not wearing a mask, not following government directive, and then you know, being a hazard to the public in general. In any case, I think, you know, this is where we will wrap up our so-called vlog that I wanted to attempt, and maybe if anything more interesting happens throughout the day. There have been a couple of things which are supposed to happen. You know, if they do happen, I'll try to include it. I'll try to make it like a, you know, vlog thing where you know, I'm covering out like whatever's happening. But the rest of the stuff is almost completely boring, because it's, you know, confidential client meetings, it's discussions which are again confidential. Not much left to be said. You know, if there's any other tidbit, I'll kind of add to that. But thank you for bearing through all of this if you've actually sat down. And I never really ask people to do this, but if you like what I'm putting out, it will really be helpful if you can kind of share these videos, share whatever you like. If you can like, press the like button that tells whatever platform I'm putting this out on that this video is appreciated. And I get a lot of love. I just hope that the love keeps coming, and God is as grateful as always. And hopefully, you know, day after tomorrow when I go, I'll have something more to kind of give to, you know, the people who are watching, rather than just saying, you know, judge was again on leave, or you know, maybe the investigating officer did not come, or any of these other things that keep happening because of which litigation is very, very slow. But anyways, until next time.